Hello friends, welcome to G-Centric. So this is the last topic in this chapter in the advanced solving techniques, that is the source transformation. Okay, so now what do we mean by source transformation? In the word itself we have got source, so it means changing the one source, that is voltage source or current source, to their opposite sources. So if it is voltage source, then we can convert to voltage source, and if it is voltage source, we can convert it into current source. So it is vice versa. So now if you have given a circuit diagram having voltage source, and what type of voltage sources you can transform from one source to another, it should be always practical voltage or current source. So now if we have got this two elements in the circuit, you have got voltage source V, okay, so this is the practical voltage source connected with the resistor in series. So this is the practical voltage source. Now if you want to convert it into practical current source, okay, so now I'll convert this into practical current source. So in practical current source, the resistor will be connected in parallel, okay. Now why did I make this arrow up? That is because positive, whenever you get the voltage source in this way, if the positive is upwards, then always the current source head will be in the upward direction. If minus and plus is given, then the direction of current source will be downwards. Okay, so now converting from this to this, we have to write in this way. Okay, so the value of R will be same, it will be kept as it is, but the value of I will be solved using the Ohm's law. So I is equal to V upon R. So this will be the value of current source. Now how do we convert current source to voltage source? So if you have got current source, okay, resistor is connected in parallel, then if you want to convert it into voltage source, the resistor value will be same. Now the direction is downwards, so the plus will be down and the negative polarity will be upside. So this value of voltage source will be using Ohm's law, that is I into R. This is the source transformation. But the source transformation, okay, it's a very difficult concept. You cannot apply for all the networks. Okay, we'll see using this, solving this problem. Okay, we'll keep that in mind and solve the problem of the find I3 ohm and I6 ohm. So first we will solve this by nodal analysis, so that we will be sure that we will be able to get the correct answer. Then we will apply the source transformation technique to solve that problem. Now we have to find the current in this 3 ohm and current in this 6 ohm. Okay, so this node voltage is same, this is same, this is V. Okay, we have 18 volt here. Okay, so once we find the value of V, then we can find the value of 3 and we can find the value of 6. Okay, so here this is V minus 18 upon 3, then this is outgoing 3 amperes, then what we have V upon 6 equal to 0. Okay, so now 6 is the LCM, 2V minus 36 plus 18, then we have V equal to 0. So 2V, 3V is equal to 18. Okay, if I have sent this 18 that side, so V is equal to 6 volts. So the value of this node voltage is 6 volts. So once we have got the 6 volts, we can find the value of this I3 ohm. Okay, so I3 ohm is nothing but, we know that this is 6 volt, means this 18 volt is at higher potential. So this is 18 minus 6 upon 3. So this is 12 upon 3, which is equal to 4 ampere. So I'll write it here, I3 ohm value is 4 ampere. Now coming to this, I6 ohm is nothing but V upon 6. So the value of V is 6, this is 1 ampere. So I'll write it here, I6 ohm is equal to 1 ampere. Okay, now we will use the source transformation technique to solve this problem. So we are sure that we need to get the value of I3 as 4 ampere and the value of I6 as 1 ampere. Okay, so now we will solve using the source transformation technique. So first we will convert this 18 volt voltage source to current source. If I have to do that, then I will redraw this circuit. The arrowhead should be upwards. Okay, so this will be in parallel. Now we have one more parallel resistor and we have got 3 ampere. Okay, so this is I is equal to nothing but V upon R, 18 by 3. So 6 ampere current is flowing. This is 3 ohm, this is 6 ohm and this is 3 ampere. Okay, now we know that from this branch we have 6 ampere current. Okay, but since we have two current sources, what we will do, 6 ampere is at the highest greater value. So we will transform it into one current source. Okay, so this is 3 ohms, this is 6 ohms. So 6 minus 3, we will get 3 ampere. Now I can apply current division rule to find the current in the I3 ohm and I6 ohm. So to find the current of I3 ohm, I'll take the resistor opposite, 3 plus 6 is 9 into 3. So it is 2 ampere. Next for I6 ohm, it is 3 upon 9 into 3. So 3 threes are 9, that is 1 ampere. Okay. So now once we have converted from voltage to current, now we'll convert this current into voltage source. So I'll write this voltage source as it is. 18 volts, then we have got 3 ohm, then I am converting this, then one more resistor. Okay, the value of this V will be I into R, so I is 3 into value of resistor is 6, 18 volts. Okay, now this value of is nothing but 6 ohms. Apply KVL in the loop, plus 18 volts. Then this is the direction of the current. Okay, so if it is the direction of the current, then what we will get, minus I3 ohm, then we have got minus 18, sorry, the direction is wrong. Okay, the I have taken polarity is wrong, so this is minus and this will be plus. So this is plus 18, then minus I6 ohm equal to 0. Okay, now I will write 18 plus 18 is 36 minus how much I will get, this is 6, this is 3 minus 9 I, because it is a series network, same amount of current will be flowing in the whole of the circuit. Okay, so I will be 4 amperes. Okay, so this is same for I3 ohm as well as for I6 ohm also, it is 4 amperes. Now compare with the original node analysis answer. So you've got I3 ohm is 4 ampere, but you are getting 2 ampere here. So I6 ohm you have got 1 ampere, here also it is 1 ampere. This both is remaining same because I6 ohm is remaining same value. That is because we haven't converted this source to the this current source to the voltage source in this case. Okay, so this is case 1 and case 2. So in case 1 we have converted the voltage to current source, but not current to voltage source. Similarly in this case, this amount of value remains same, that is for I3 ohm it is 4 ampere, but for I6 it is not the same value. That is because we have kept the voltage source as it is in this side of the circuit, but for this part we have source transformed. So that is why we are getting the different answer. So now it means that whenever in a circuit, if the response is asked in any of these branches, okay, in that branch we cannot make the source transformation. So response, it can be either voltage, it can be current or power in the branch. So whenever they have asked the response in that particular branch, then you are not allowed to use the source transformation technique to find the answer. Otherwise you will get the wrong answers. Okay, so that is why this is the most confused technique, and most of them get confused. Okay, so remembering one point in this technique is, if the response is asked in that branch, in that particular branch, then you are not going to apply the source transformation technique. So this completes the unit 5, that is the advanced solving techniques. So we have left with only power and energy, concept. We'll do it in the next lecture. And if we finish that, the DC analysis is finished, then we'll move on to the AC analysis of the network. Okay, thank you.